آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وبارك وسلم صلاة وسلاما عليك يا سيدي يا رسول الله، صلاة وسلاما عليك يا سيدي يا حبيب الله، صلاة وسلاما عليك يا سيدي يا رحمة للعالمين، وعلى آلك وأصحابك يا شفيع المذنبين. حمد وثناء کے بعد واجب الاحترام حاضرین مجلس، محترم بزرگوں، عزیز نوجوانوں، محترم مائیں بہنیں، السلام علیکم ورحمۃ اللہ تعالی وبرکاتہ. اللہ رب العزت جل جلالہ وعم نوالہ کا فضل و کرم اور احسان عظیم ہے کہ اس نے ہمیں پھر سے یہ موقع عطا فرمایا کہ آج we are gathered in this masjid to celebrate the urs of مبلغ اسلام حضرت علامہ مولانا الشاہ محمد عبد العلیم صدیقی مدنی نور اللہ مرقدہ. Sitting together and remember the friends of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and ulama ahl sunnah, especially those ulama who have spent their entire life to spread the love of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and to make the love of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam understood by each and every human being in the world. Those people who dedicate themselves to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to the mission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Those people, when they leave their homes, when they leave their houses, they don't think that they'll be able to come back to their homes, or they don't think that they'll be able to come back to their houses. Because once they skip the first step outside their house, the only intention they have is to dedicate and to invest and to sacrifice each and every moment coming after putting the first step out of their houses for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and for the sake of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So when someone has this kind of intention and someone decides to sacrifice himself for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and for the sake of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, once they leave their homes or they leave their houses, they never wish to come back without bringing back the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or the pleasure of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. In the history, we have so many examples in front of us from the beginning of Islam, from the first, the father of all Anbiya and the father of all human beings, سيدنا وسندنا حضرت آدم على نبينا وعليه الصلاة والسلام till our life of today. History is telling us that many examples has been coming in front of us, that each and every moment is being spent for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and for the sake of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And among those examples, the very fresh example is the example of the grooving ambassador, مبلغ Islam, حضرت علامة سيدنا وسندنا الشاه محمد عبد العليم الصديقي المدني رضي الله تعالى عنه. Today, it is the duty of everyone who has a slightly love for this roving ambassador of the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for this مبلغ Islam, حضرت علامة مولانا عبد العليم صديقي مدني رضي الله تعالى عنه. Those who claim that maybe they have been the murid of مولانا عبد العليم, or those who have the love of this Siddiqi silsila, it is the duty of everyone to try his or her level best to put his or her life in the circle of the sunnah of these great awliya Allah and these great ulama-i deen who have spent their entire life to spend the love of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and to teach people the real picture of Islam and of the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It is very good to claim that we love this awliya Allah. It is very sweet and good sounding to hear that we love and we have so good feelings for these awliya Allah and these ulama-i deen. But on the other hand, if we find ourselves out of the track and we find ourselves away, far away from the teachings and from the practice of these ulama and these awliya Allah, so it is the time to ask ourselves that what kind of love we have for this awliya Allah, and what kind of love we have for this ulama, and what kind of emotions we have for this awliya Allah, what kind of attachment we have for this ulama-i deen. It is very important, my dear brothers and sisters, not only verbally claim that we love this awliya Allah, but with all our hearts, minds and souls to implement the love of this awliya Allah practically, and at least try to follow the sunnah of this awliya Allah. I know they are so high in terms of rank and they have reached the highest horizons of the closeness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, where not so easily for someone to reach to those horizons, but it is our duty, because our love will always compel us to follow and to try to put our steps in the circle of this awliya Allah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enable us love this awliya Allah and these ulama-i deen, not only verbally, but at least to try to put one step forward to follow the footsteps of this awliya Allah. And inshallah, definitely, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will enable us and will boost us to be able to put ourselves completely and totally into the lives of this awliya Allah. وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين.